It is 6:30 p.m. here in Redmond, Washington, but on the other side of the world, in Shanghai, it is like 10:30 a.m. And so I'm going to be chatting with Zihao, who is a Microsoft student ambassador and an MVP. And he has an insane video channel in China where he's teaching like hundreds of thousands of people how to code and how to get started in artificial intelligence. And the community that he's managed to build up in a really short period of time is just amazing to me. And so I had to sit down with him to hear about what he's doing, how we got into coding, and what his code story is. So let's check it out. How are you?
Yeah, hi. Thanks for this opportunity.
Awesome, fantastic. Well, tell us a little bit about yourself.
Hi, my name is Zihao, a student from Tongji University, Shanghai. And I have a video channel about artificial intelligence, machine learning, Python programming, deep learning, computer vision, and Raspberry Pi. And I have many tutorials of error and cognitive service, such as custom vision. I'm looking forward to sharing my experience about technology, open source, content creation, and community.
I love it. I love it. So we were talking a little bit earlier, and you were telling me about how you got into computer science and programming, and it's a little bit different than what you were planning on doing when you went to college. So tell me a little bit about how you switched your focus areas.
I majored in civil engineering when I was an undergraduate. To be honest, at that time, I hate coding. I never write a single line of code. My major, civil engineering, focuses on all kinds of construction and infrastructure, such as design and build architecture, house, tunnel, a bridge, and a railway. Nothing but mechanics and dynamics. The scene changed in 2018 when I was an exchange student in the University of Pennsylvania. There was a lecture in Wharton School inviting the CEO of Microsoft, Nadella. He shared his insights about blockchain, quantum computing, as well as open source communities such as GitHub.
Most people sort of say it's the AI versus the human. I think we have to sort of first grab hold of all the opportunities AI creates to empower humans.
Later, I found GitHub, this amazing website. I learned lots of open source toolkits, such as VS Code, Keras, even Bitcoin on this website. In GitHub, you can cooperate with developers all over the world. And I started to study Python programming, data analysis, algorithms, machine learning, AI, deep learning, computer vision, front-end development with eager and hunger. Of course, that was not an easy way. I used to get stuck in a Python bug or dealing with data structure issues for the whole afternoon or the whole day. At the same time, I started to write technical blogs and make technical videos.
And so you were making these videos and writing these blogs because you didn't want other people to have to maybe struggle the way that you were struggling in the beginning, right?
My first video was about convolutional neural networks. That's a breakthrough algorithms in deep learning and computer vision. Help us to do image classification, object detection, and image recognition. Later, I found myself good at making this kind of hardcore tutorials. And more subscribers make me more confident. And I think this could be the career of my lifetime. We aim to help zero beginner and cross-field learners like me quickly master data mining, machine learning, AI in easy to understand way and quickly apply what they have learned into real scenario projects.
I love that.
Actually, my video channel covers all kinds of fields related to computer science, especially in computer vision. My video channel covers mathematics, machine learning, basics, deep learning, neural networks, computer vision, Python programming, data analysis, data visualization, and edge computing. especially we focus on computer vision, because computer vision is telling a computer how to extract information or recognize information from images or videos. And computer vision, also called CV, is a basic application in artificial intelligence. It contains image classification, object detection, semantic segmentation, instance segmentation, and also object tracking, 3D vision. Let me show you an example.
Okay.
This is object detection. Object detection means drawing rectangle boxes on an image. And with this algorithm, you can do fine-tuning and transfer learning. If you are a doctor, you can use this algorithm to detect tumors and pneumonia on X-ray. And if you are a farmer, you can use this algorithm to detect crop disease. That depends on you. This can empower lots of fields and lots of professions, and is widely used in different scenarios. And lots of students from traditional majors, they can really benefit from computer vision.
That's such a good, you know, demo and a good visualization of what you're doing. What I guess kind of led you to continuing to create these videos? Were you making them as you were continuing to learn?
Exactly. More and more people in China, like me, especially students from those traditional majors such as mechanicals, finance, they want to get into the IT world too. They want to use advanced machine learning to empower their own profession and their own major. I think with my experience, I believe I can really help them simplify the learning curve. Let me show you another example. I major in civil engineering and especially high-speed railway. And the Chinese have a huge high-speed railway and urban railway system. And how to detect and maintain the health of this kind of infrastructure is of vital importance. That's what I can do to break the ceiling of the traditional engineering. This video is detect railway track, shelling, cracking, checking, damage, corrugation, and fatigue fracture on the running surface of the railway. And we can expect that in the future, everything is related to data, and everything is data-driven.
Yeah, no, we were talking about that earlier, about how important you think it is that people actually try things in order to learn them, and that's how you've learned a lot, is by doing things. Can you talk a little bit about that?
For example, if you are an agriculture expert or a farmer, this is a traditional job with a long history. You can utilize new technologies such as UAV drones, remote sensing, and computer vision to do lots of things, breaking the ceiling of traditional agriculture. Now you don't even need to write code or learn algorithms. There are lots of out-of-box toolkit such as custom vision in error cognitive service. You can just upload your datasets, train and deploy the AI models just by clicking your mouse. This is also a demo to do the crop disease image recognition. If you are a farmer or an expert in agriculture, you just need to upload your photos, and the artificial intelligence will detect and recognize which disease does your crop have with high accuracy and high precision.
I love that. And you have 340,000 subscribers across different platforms, is that right?
Yeah, and in the future, there will be more.
Which is incredible. But and you started doing this in what, 2018?
Yeah, I started from 2018, but during the pandemic, the online education became more and more popular. That's how I get more popular.
It would make sense that students especially would really get value out of your channel, and especially the fact that, you know, you present things in an interesting way and you use real world examples. So it makes total sense that this is where a lot of your subscribers have come from.
Also, like I said before, you don't need to write code, or even you don't need to learn algorithm, because there are already many out of the box toolkit such as custom vision in error cognitive service. You just upload your data, and the error will help you handle everything, help you train or deploy the models. You just need to click the mouse.
I'm curious, we were talking earlier and you said that there haven't been a lot of resources for people in China who speak Mandarin to, you know, learn. We have a lot of documentation in English, but not as much in Mandarin. So has that been a good opportunity for you?
I have made a series of videos to help you read academic paper of artificial intelligence, especially computer vision. I took detailed notes of every formula, every graph, every reference, the paper.
And what's so interesting, you know, you're showing these papers that you've annotated in Chinese, you've added these notes, but you were telling me that some of your content that you create in Chinese has actually been translated into other languages for other people in other parts of the world. Have you had a lot of people in your community helping contribute to your content as well?
Yeah, actually, I have a big team. The team member not only from my own team, my own school, but also from my subscribers in all kinds of fields and all kinds of professions.
I love that you're focusing on all those ways to you know, get the most out of what you're doing, and then also helping people in all parts of the world potentially be able to do that too. It's not just one thing, which is what makes open source so great, is that it can be global, and it's what makes the community that you're building so great. So in addition to having your video channels and your tutorials, I know that you also work as an MVP and a Microsoft Student Ambassador. Can you tell me a little bit about the work that you do there?
Microsoft supports Microsoft Student Club in hundreds of universities in China. Also in my college, Tongji University, Shanghai, we have the opportunity to work with Microsoft experts from Microsoft Research Asia, also called MSRA, on various cutting-edge projects. We make a whole open source community of AI education called AIEDU. Let me show you a GitHub page.
That's awesome.
And also there are many Chinese college students take part in this open source repository and contribute themselves. And MVP means most valuable professional. And MVP is the technical expert and community leader, as well as open source advocates. Not only do they write blogs and make videos, but also they will give feedback on Microsoft products. And we also take part in important activities in the community, such as Microsoft Ignite Conference, Microsoft Build Connect Conference, AI Bootcamp, and MSA means Microsoft Student Ambassador. And MSA members come from university students all over the world. Many of them are college students. You can make friends with them, and you can communicate technical issues and even report a bug.
That's awesome. Have you made a lot of friends in the community?
Yeah. MSA members from all over the world.
I love that. I love that. I have a question for you. For if somebody is, whether they're a student or maybe they're just looking to get started, what's your advice for someone who is coming from a different background, you know, like you, who wasn't a typical computer science major? What's your advice for them on getting started?
Here is the learning path I recommend. You need to take four crucial steps. And the first is mathematics, such as linear algebra, probability statistics, and calculus. And the second step is coding and programming. I recommend Python and JavaScript. And Python is popular not only because it's a very easy to learn programming language, but also Python have a huge open source ecosystem and the computing ecosystem. There are lots of three-party libraries, toolkits, such as scikit-learn, Keras, and you can use them to make your own application. So learning Python is of vital importance in this period of time. And the third step is algorithm. If you want to learn more about artificial intelligence and deep learning, you need to know the basics of convolutional neural networks, recurrent neural networks, all kinds of neural networks. You need to learn the algorithm's basic. And the last and the most important step is a real project, which means get your hands dirty. You need to learn through the real scenario project, dealing with the real scenario problem.
So what's next for you? You know, you've been making videos a lot during the pandemic, and you've been learning a lot. What's the next thing that you want to focus on?
Yeah, I have a huge plan. I will build my AI education ecosystem in 2 years. That's my dream. This process is extremely enjoyable for us from the bottom of our hearts, that we are providing high quality education resources for a huge number of future learners.
I love that. I love that. I love that you're helping people all over the world.
Yeah.
Well, Zihao, thank you so much for talking with me and for doing all the great stuff that you do. This is so cool. And I love just seeing someone like you who's so driven and who's so willing to want to teach other people. And I think that you found a really good career. And I think that this is something you're meant to do. I'm so happy to have talked to you.
Yeah. Maybe 2 years later, we can have another Code Story interview.
Let's do it. Let's plan to talk in 2 years, because I can't wait to see what you build then. I'm so impressed with everything you're doing. I think it's so great. 2 years from now, we're definitely going to talk again, because I can't wait to see what more you've accomplished. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
You know, just a couple of years ago, Zihao was a civil engineering major, and he didn't have any interest in programming at all. He saw Satya Nadella, Microsoft CEO, speak when he was at the University of Pennsylvania, and it opened up this whole new world for him. And not only has he become a really proficient programmer, but he's actually gone on to teach, you know, thousands of people from all over the world how to get started with artificial intelligence and machine learning and Python and open source. And he's building out an entire curriculum to really empower people. I think that's really incredible, and it just goes to show you that all of our code stories can be really unique and can come from really different places. And the fact that so many more people are going to be learning because of him is really exciting. We've got some resources down below where you can check out how to get started if you're interested in learning, both at docs.microsoft.com and Microsoft Learn. I also have some links to Zihao's GitHub page, because all the AI education work that he was doing while an intern at Microsoft Research is just incredible. And you know, I can't wait to see what he does next. We promised that we would talk in 2 years, so we will. But I'm gonna head out now because it's a little bit late here, but we'll see you next time. Thanks for tuning in.